Hi there, and thank you for joining us on KARE 11 News at Noon. I'm Alexis Rogers. Right now, Metro Transit Police are investigating after a bus hit and killed a pedestrian overnight in St. Paul. It happened on Ford Parkway near the intersection of McAllister Street. That's where Michelle Beck was bringing us an update from the start of the investigation.
Police say the bus hit a man as he crossed in front of it. But that's pretty much all we know about the victim at this point in time, just that he was walking and later pronounced dead on scene. In the video, you can see it was a Metro A line bus near the intersection of McAllister Street and Ford Parkway. According to Metro Transit Police, the crash happened around 12:45 a.m. With police investigating the cause of the crash, they say the bus driver will be placed on administrative leave, as is the policy. No word this morning from Metro Transit on who the driver is or their history as an employee. And when the scene was still active, we did see officials checking the front of the bus as well as go inside. We also saw the medical examiner leave the scene around 4 a.m., but a lot more investigating left to do. In St. Paul, Michelle Beck, KARE 11 News.
There are more tributes planned honoring the fallen first responders killed in this weekend's deadly standoff in Burnsville. In just over 7 hours, the Southeast Minnesota community of Wabasha will gather for candlelight vigil for Officer Matthew Ruge. He was a graduate of Wabasha Kellogg High School. This is video from last night's vigil in Burnsville. Dozens of people from all over the Twin Cities stopped by City Hall to pay their respects. Many added to the memorials that honor Ruge, as well as Officer Paul Elmstrand and firefighter paramedic Adam Finseth. Here's what's next in the investigation. The BCA is expected to release more details about the deadly standoff in the coming days. We're expecting to learn where the shooter, Shannon Cortez Gooden, got his guns. He was not allowed to have any because of a prior conviction. If you want to help out the families of the fallen first responders, you can. Text the word donate to 763-797-7215. We'll respond with a link to Burnsville's official donation site. All right, let's go ahead and talk about our weather now. Ben, I stepped outside and I was like, you know what? We got another warmer day than normal, especially for February.
Yeah, absolutely. It's another strange day. Temperatures are already well into the 40s, basically equaling our high temperature from yesterday. And even though we did start off with some sunshine, we are seeing some of these mid and high level clouds giving us more filtered sunshine during the tail end of the day. Currently 44 degrees. Parts of western and southwestern Minnesota are even knocking on the door of 50 degrees. But notice up in northern Minnesota, where we have more of a snowpack, temperatures a little bit cooler, right now sitting in the 30s. So temperatures, they are going to be on the warmer side. Right now 44 in the metro, a light southwesterly wind. Overall, a very comfortable first part of the afternoon, and it should be a very uneventful day today. Temperatures rising up into the upper 40s, and some parts of the metro could eclipse 50 degrees. We do have a bit of a roller coaster with our temperatures over the next 7 days. We'll talk about some ups and downs, and if we have any precip in the forecast, that's coming up. Alexis?
Oh man, around and around we go. Ben, thank you so much. Well, in less than 4 hours, hundreds of Minneapolis city workers will vote on a potential strike. Public works employees in charge of maintaining things like the city's roads, parks, trash, and water treatment are in the middle of a new contract negotiation. They're calling for more staff, better wages, and safer working conditions. The union is expected to announce the results of the strike vote around 6 tonight. And we're just a few hours away from the St. Paul City Council meeting, where activists are calling on members to pass a ceasefire resolution for the war in Gaza. This would mark at least the third rally since the beginning of the month. And its meeting 2 weeks ago, the council decided to avoid taking a formal stance on the war. We are less than 2 weeks out from Super Tuesday, when Minnesotans will vote in the presidential primary. Now, if you're voting on the Republican ballot, Nikki Haley says you will still see her name. She's currently 30 points behind former President Donald Trump in her home state, but says that won't be her last stop. Trump says she has no mathematical path to a nomination, but Haley is pointing to Trump's legal challenges. That includes a Supreme Court ruling coming down as soon as today on whether Colorado can bar the former president from the ballot. Well, following Saturday's vote in South Carolina, Nikki Haley is headed to Minnesota. She's planning on stopping in Bloomington on Monday. We expect more information as we get closer to the day of the visit.